So I'm just out here running, and I'm thinking to myself, as I'm getting bit over and over by mosquitoes, is this the day that I get Zika? Hey everyone, so it's the 4th of July, headed out here to, well, a trail I haven't shown you guys yet. Wabash Heritage Trail starts up here at the Tippecanoe Battlefield Memorial. It's pretty nice when it's all open, about 12, 13 miles long, so you can get pretty good full marathon run in just on an out and back if you wanted to. It's closed off right now by a bridge they're repairing. Can't do the whole thing, but I think you can go out about 5 or 6 miles. So I'm gonna try and do that, do an out and back. I'd like to get 15 miles in today. At least I really need to start bumping up my long runs now that hopefully I'm healthy again. So, yeah, I'm here and I'm ready to go. I'm not gonna really waste a whole lot of time. Got my whole pack together. I am drinking a Red Bull because I'm just really feeling the last couple days, just kind of down and out, like just really hard to get out and run, trying to get some extra energy. But yeah, here we go. There. This is the Barkley section of the course. Although, I think if I was to go through there, maybe that would be better training. This is pretty easy going. So far, at almost 2 miles. Hasn't been bad so far. Spider webs aren't too bad, bugs aren't too bad. It's a little muddy, but you know, overall, really nice run. It's been really hot because this trail is just kind of grown over. So you're like running through a tunnel the whole time, and we're not close to the water yet. We're close to the creek, but it's not giving off a whole lot of cool air. So it's been pretty freaking hot. You got me waiting. There and across the bridge. That's boring. It was cooler when it was a crossing. Crossing the rocks. So I don't twist a freaking ankle here. Okay, we're freaking chilling. Mudfest for the last like mile. doesn't look like it's getting any better until right until I cross the river up here. But you can see here, this is where Burnett Creek meets up with the Wabash, right over there. But, oh, shit, I gotta run. Eating alive. Plus this mud, it's just like, sapping the energy. My shoes are like ice skates right now. Because of all this thick, like, river mud. It's stuck on them right now. The steps are like right over here. Jeez. Buddy, in case you're wondering. I was calling out to men, put my eyes on the wall. You were running like a ghost from me. You were running from it all. You got me waiting, I'm on fire. You got me waiting, my desire. That is the way to the car. That is the way to more miles. I said, you know, what the heck? I'm at 10 and a half miles. It's not easy to get here. Might as well do a couple more. So, I'm gonna head out to Prophet's Rock, is what it's called, and get a loop in there. It might only be like an extra mile. Might only be like an extra mile or mile and a half, but I'm gonna do it. So this is the Prophet's Rock Trail. And it's got a little bit of climbing. So I'm at 450 feet right now for 10.7 miles. Different comes across the road. And it just feels like a totally different place because it's not like kind of swampy like the other side Wabash Heritage Trail is. This more feels a lot more like a just typical Indiana trail. Zika or poison ivy? Maybe both. So, about 11.7 miles, 2 hours and 47 minutes. Not my best run ever, not my worst. So that's it. You got to see the Wabash Heritage Trail. little bit of Prophet's Rock. Good trails, but not good conditions today. Just super muddy, buggy, pretty nasty run, but good training. Glad it's done. All right, that's the end. See you later.